Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel Leela Web Dev. In this video, we will learn about the another method, that is return values. So what is this return values and why we use this return values? Let's try to see. In our previous video, we have seen about this return value. When we want to return a single value, when we are trying to return a single value, we will use this return value method. So that means, so whenever you call this multiply method in this spec, whenever you call this multiply method, it will return only a single value, that is returns a value like that. Okay. So other than that, it will not return anything. Now, if you want to return multiple values, then you can use another method, that is return values. So why we need to use this multiple values? Why we want to return multiple values? Let's try to see in our main.js. So here in this main.js, if you try to see, this is the calculate method, and in this calculate method, when you call something like expression 3 plus 3, when you are doing the addition, the first time we are calling the calculator.add method. Okay. So when we are calling this add method, so we don't care about this return value. So we are not caring about this return value. Whatever the return value it may be, so we are not caring about that one. Now when you go to the switch case and when we are doing this again, the calculator.add, so this time the result matters. So that means we need to have this return value. So that means at the first time when we are calling this add value, we are not caring about the return. And the second time when we are calling this add method, then we are caring about this return value. So that means first time we don't want about the result, and second time we want about the result. So with that result only, we will update the result in the DOM. So this is the best scenario where we can see the return multiple return values. Why we want to use this multiple return values is because we directly don't rely on the actual implementation in our unit test. So we are not relying on the implementation of this calculator.add like this in the unit test. So we are spying on this method. So we know that we are spying on this method. So first time when we are calling, we don't want to send the result. So we don't want to return any value, but the second time we want to return the value. So the use case is like this. So if you want to implement this, you can also implement like that. So let's try to see it. So for example, if I go here and if I try to paste it down. So here I am using the return values. Now here I will be using this return values. Now I am spying on the method add, and here I will do 3 plus 3, something like this. Okay. Now the return values. So we know that when we are calling this return add method in our calculate method, when we are calling this add method, so we know that the first time we don't return any value. So here you can give something like comma oriented. So here you can give the comma oriented like this. So how many times you are calling this method. So in which call you want to return what value, you can use this like this comma oriented. So for example, if the calculate.add method is calling 4 times, means you can use 4 comma oriented like this, or otherwise you can loop over the dynamic values and you can pass it like this. Okay. Either way is okay. So now first time we don't return any value. So we don't care about the return value. So we are passing the null, and the second time I want to return the value. So I am using this second call. Now when we are spying on this add method, and when we are calling this calculate, if you go to this main.js, in this calculate method, so first time when this add method is called, we are spying on this add method. So now here the return value will be nothing, null. And the second time when we are calling this add method, now we are sending the result. Okay. Now we are trying to send the result. So second call. Now let's try to see it. Expect. So here we are calling this one. Now let's try to see the output. If I try to see the output, here it is telling that expected SI spy but got function. So here we are getting an error. Let's try to see it. So to have been called with like this. And here why we are getting this error is, okay, here we are spying on this multiply, right? We need to spy on this add method. Okay. Now if I try to see, expected spy update result to have been called with returns a value, but actual call was second call. Yeah, that's one is fine. Now what I will try to do here, I can copy this one and I can paste it here. Second call. Okay. Now let's try to see it. So if I try to see successfully the return value has been passed. Now if you go into this one in the implementation, now here the return value is getting up, it is getting passed as an argument to the update result, and we are able to successfully see that update result has been called and update result is taking the value second call. For example, if you remove this result thing, okay, now if you remove this result thing, now immediately you will get an error that expected spy updated to have been called with second call, but actual call is undefined. So like this, we will be able to find the error. So now must and should it should take the value. So this is how we can find the bugs in the logic. So here we are, what this return values is doing. So whenever how many times the add method is called, so for each call, so if it is called first time, what we need to return, second time what we need to return, if you want to return that based on the calling priority, means you can use this return values, whereas you can use this comma oriented, so that for the first time when the add is called, so null will be returned, and the second time when the add is called, second call, like this it will go on send the value. So how many times this add will be called in this calculate method, so those many times it will return the value. So hope you understood about this one. So return values, so what is the difference between this return value and return values? Return value only will return only single value. Whenever how many times you call this multiply method or anything, so many times you call it, it will always return a single value. But whereas here, so based on the calling priority, so how many times you are calling, for which time we need to return the value, particular value means, so we can return the value. For first call you want to return a particular value, or for the second call you want to return a particular value means, so you can use this return values. With the comma oriented, it will return the value, so based on how many times it has been called. Hope you understood about this return values. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, please do support me by subscribing to my channel. Thank you.